ispada. Mi smo neki... Na Balkanu i taj neki put Beograda, duh Balkana se najbolje osjeća ovdje. Prvo da pukamo u sredini. Beograd nije mnogo lep grad, iako se zove Beograd, ali kada pogledate više puta je bombardovan, dosta je bio puta urušen i nije toliko beo koliko je siv. Ali ljudi su ono što čini Beograd. To je ta duša, to su ljudi u kojima ja pišem, ljudi koji spajaju staro i novo.
The overlap between old and new is tangible in Dorćol. The first district that was built outside of the city walls, between Skadarlia and Kalemegdan Park, on the banks of the Danube, it is Belgrade's smallest neighborhood. Slowly but surely, this district, with its dilapidated charm, is changing. Alongside its crumbling facades are designer shops, high-class restaurants, and the most expensive apartments in the city, all an attraction for visitors. The cafes and clubs are forcing out traditional workshops and family stores, but at least one shop is resisting the tide of gentrification. The perfumer, Nenad Jovanov.
Wow, prvi put sam u ovakvom vreme plovu. Poštovanje, Nenad, Filje.
Također, Nenad, imenjenci smo.
Ovde baš ima svašta zanimljivo.
Kako da ne? Pa pazite, gdje ste ušli u neku vrstu vreme plova? Jer se praktično od 50-ih ništa nije promenilo.
Znači, to je jedna od komponenata za toaletnu vodu.
Za toaletnu vodu. Naravno, postupak proizvodnje parfema je sličan i razlikuje se obično samo u nekim količinama.
Nenad Jovanov is a third generation perfumer. His father opened the shop in 1954. The ingredients of the colognes and perfumes have not changed much over the years, only the taste of those living in the neighborhood.
Koliko se Dorćol za sve ove godine promenio?
Pa moram priznati, prilično. Međutim, ostali su detalji koji vas bukvalno mogu vratiti u vremenskom smislu, unazad u izvorno vreme kada je ovo bila prva trgovačka ulica van utvrđenja. Možda taj duh koji je uspeo da preživi, da je ovo to mesto gde vi dolazite bilo šta želeći da kupite, dolazite ovde i u ovoj ulici, odnosno u ovom kraju, možete sve to što ste poželeli nabaviti.
Marina Aleksić is one of the younger generation living in Dorćol. Her father is the third generation shop owner. The family has always produced traditional Serbian dress. Marina grew up amongst the colorful cloth and stitching, and almost by chance, it inspired her own business idea.
Pa zapravo je krivac jedna slika koja je izašla na Instagramu, na društvenoj mreži, koju sam ja privatno koristila i slikala sam se u tom delu nošnje. To je zapravo... ovaj. To su dugački prsluci, to je zubuni koji imaju po sebi različite vrste ručnog rada i to je moje drugarice podsjetilo na neke kreatore svetske poznate i onda su me pitale ko je to brand, šta, gde si kupila. Ja kad im kažem da je to deo nošnje, one prosto nisu verovale, takav utisak ima.
The clothes are entirely handmade. Some of the cloths and details are even woven according to the old techniques. Every region in Serbia has a unique style. Nowadays, the pieces are only made to order, usually for folk organizations in Serbia and abroad. Marina's grandmother is an expert in fine stitching.
Bravo.
Ciao.
Šta radiš to?
Evo, šijemo.
Ja, to je sa srebrnim.
Jeste.
Super, divno. Pa ja to mogu da ponesem sa sobom. To je da baš je za tebe. Odlično, tamo mogu i da ga slikam.
Baš.
Baš je lijep. Baš.
Once a week, Marina takes original pieces from the workshop to sell in her shop in Dorćol. What started out as fun has become much more than just a hobby. Together with her boyfriend, she adapts the traditional clothes to contemporary fashion by making small changes.